Hello, I'm David Kerr, and you're watching Shalom World News. Here are your latest news headlines from around the globe. The French Prime Minister says that the martyrdom of Father Jaques Hamel, who was murdered 4 years ago by two Islamist attackers, gave France the strength to unite in the face of terrorist barbarism. Jean Castex made his comments this week on Twitter upon the anniversary of Father Hamel's murder. The 85-year-old cleric was killed on July the 26th, 2016, while offering Holy Mass in the parish church of Saint-Étienne-du-Rouvray near Rouen in Normandy. Mr. Castex recalled how at that moment France, struck in her heart, discovered Jaques Hamel, his face and his message. It was this, he said, that gave the French people the strength to confront terrorism. The anniversary of Father Hamel's murder also saw a Mass for the dead offered in the parish church where he was slain. It was followed outside the church by a ceremony of peace and fraternity. Among the religious and political leaders in attendance were France's Minister of the Interior, Gérald Darmanin, and Archbishop Éric de Moulin-Beaufort of Reims. The Vatican has reaffirmed its commitment to protecting the rights of victims of human trafficking. That commitment was made during the 20th Conference of the Alliance Against Trafficking in Persons, held last week in Austria. Among the participants was Monsignor Joseph Grech from the Holy See's permanent mission to the international organisations in Vienna. He noted the discrepancy between the high number of victims and the low rate of prosecutions and convictions of human traffickers. Monsignor Grech suggested that this was due in large measure to the lack of resources put into combating human trafficking by many governments. Too often, he said, this can lead to states focusing on immediate results rather than trying to catch, quote, the big fish in the world of human trafficking. The two-day conference in Austria was organised in collaboration with the Organisation for Security and Cooperation in Europe, or OSCE, under the title of Ending Impunity, Delivering Justice Through Prosecuting Trafficking in Human Beings. The United States of America is in an extraordinary hour of cultural conflict. That's a stark assessment of the US Conference of Catholic Bishops, or USCCB. It's been made in response to reports of increasing incidents of church vandalism and fires across the North American country. The comment was made on behalf of the USCCB by the chairman of their Committee on Religious Liberty, Archbishop Thomas Wensky of Miami, and the chairman of the Committee on Domestic Justice and Human Development, Archbishop Paul Coakley of Oklahoma City. The two bishops said that the path forward for all Americans must be through the compassion and understanding practiced and taught by Jesus Christ and His Holy Mother. In recent weeks, statues of the Virgin Mary have been defaced, set on fire, and even beheaded in various locations across the United States. The two bishops say that Catholics should respond to confusion with understanding and to hatred with love. Pope Francis has sent a letter of congratulations to a Spanish boy with a mental health condition who has just completed the Camino de Santiago pilgrimage across the north of Spain. 15-year-old Alvaro Calenti's father wrote to Pope Francis to inform him of his son's pilgrim journey, which was also charted along the way on social media. In return, the Holy Father wrote to say that he admired Alvaro's courage in undertaking the journey during the COVID-19 crisis. He thanked young Alvaro for his daring, his sincerity, his joy and his cheerfulness, which, said the Pope, would spark hope in the many people he met along the way or through social media. Finally, Ireland's largest Catholic youth event will take place next month, but only online due to COVID-19 restrictions. The Youth 2000 Summer Eve Festival will be held from the 14th to the 16th of August. The organisers say that the virtual attendees this year will still find opportunities to experience the love of God, to receive the grace of conversion, and also to discern a call to priesthood or religious life. Youth 2000 is a Catholic youth organisation which hosts festivals, retreats, prayer groups and other events for young people across Ireland. It was founded in the UK by Englishman Ernest Williams in response to Pope St John Paul II's call for a new evangelisation. Youth 2000 began in Ireland in 1993 and now has spread to 25 countries across the globe. Well, that's all for now. Do join me next time for some more news headlines from across the globe. Until then, may God bless you. Shalom.